Hi everyone, Erin Turner here from Smart Business Solutions. It is another lockdown here in Victoria again, but there is some small good news. The Victorian government has released some small COVID-19 support payments for small businesses. And today we're going to walk through how to record these state government grants in Xero. So to start off, we're going to show you how to create a new chart of account in Xero, and then secondly, how to actually reconcile that in Xero also. So what we're going to do is jump over into our Xero file. Sorry, bear with me. There we go. So your Xero file should look something like this when you do log in. So at the moment, we're sitting on our dashboard. When you go to reconcile your bank account, so you've already applied for the state grant that's currently available, and you've noticed you've just received it in your bank account today, it will look something very similar to this, so from the Victorian State Government of either $4,800 or something similar, but you're not actually sure where to reconcile it to. So what we're going to do is head up to the Accounting tab and down to Chart of Accounts, and we're going to set up a new account for it. So what we're going to do is actually head to over to the Revenue tab. So this is going to show you all revenue accounts that you currently have set up in your Xero file. So you may have as little as this, or you may have a lot more. So you'll notice here that there's two different types. You've got revenue and other income. So everything in this revenue should really be anything relating to your business income. So the sales account for your goods or services that you sell. And then anything under the other income should really be anything else. So you'll see things like interest income, JobKeeper payments that you may have been entitled to, and even another state government grant chart of account that you may have had set up for your previous grants that you received. Now you can obviously use that account again. I just would be very cautious because very recently the Parliament actually just passed the new bill that made all COVID-19 support payments for the financial year 2022, so this current financial year that we're in, they've made all these support payments tax-free. So what this means, they're non-assessable, non-exempt. So come year end when you go to do your tax return, previously, you got that $4,800 grant, you used to actually pay tax on it, whereas now you don't actually have to pay tax on it at all. So it's a nice incentive for you businesses out there. So what we're going to do is actually create a new one. So if you go to add account, and like I said, we're going to do it under the other income because it's not really relating to our business income of our goods and services. Now the account code, as long as it's unique, that's okay really. So you can see here there is a bit of a system that we do have. So anything in the revenue is currently within the 200s. So we're just going to keep it similar. So we're going to go for 250. Oh, that shouldn't be like that. We'll try again. Just to be safe, we'll do 255. And then now we're going to just call this chart of account Victorian Government Grant. And in brackets, I'm going to go N-A-N-E. So this just means non-assessable, non-exempt. And you can really call this anything that you would like, but you do want it to be easy to identify. And it's not needed that you put this at the end of your chart of account, but I would recommend it just so then when come to year end, it's definitely not missed, and because you don't really want to pay tax on a payment that you don't actually have to pay tax on. Also really important to change this tax code to BAS excluded, because like I said, it's non-assessable, non-exempt, so you don't really want to be accidentally paying GST to the ATO for that one either. And then click save. So you can see here now that I've saved it, it has popped down in my list of revenues. So when I go into the dashboard and I'm now going to reconcile my bank account, when I get to that Victorian State Government, I can now enter in who it's for, so Victorian State Government. And then I can easily search by using the drop-down and scrolling through, or I can search for that account code, or even by searching for the grant, it will pop up there. Now, the description, you don't have to put anything in. It's just really handy. So when you go to review this transaction later on, you can see exactly what it was for. So you can even put, the exact reference to the grant or whatever it might be. But for today, I'm just going to allocate it directly to that income account I've just created and click OK. So now if I was to run my profit and loss, you'd be able to see that government grant correctly reconciled. So that's the end of today's walkthrough video. I would like to see you guys like and subscribe to our YouTube channel. This is just so you don't miss out on any other walkthrough videos for Xero. And you can see we've also got a lot of other great content out there. And obviously, if you do have any questions at all, please feel free to reach out to us at Smart Business Solutions. We've got our contact details on the screen there. Thank you, everyone.